Thank you, sir. Good morning, everyone. I feel fortunate and take the pride and pleasure to introduce today's introductory guest speaker, Mrs. Manjari Sandeep Ghar, Vice President of Indian Pharmaceutical Association, IPA, and Chairperson of Community Pharmacy Division of IPA. Presently, she is the Chair of International Pharmaceutical Federation, FIP, Commission on Antimicrobial Resistance, AMR. And Vice President of International Pharmaceutical Federation, FIP. And apart from this, she is also an executive member of Southeast Asian Region, SEAR, FIP, WHO Forum, and continues to be in academic as Principal of Principal K.M. Kundnani Pharmacy Polytechnic, Mumbai, India. She is a key figure, a project leader of IPS.TB Pharmacist Project, which is a public-private partnership project. A TB team expert, she has roles in WHO staff, tuberculosis department, Geneva. Back in India, she is IPS campaign leader for awareness and responsible use of medicine, CARM. Mrs. Manjari is an awesome, inspiring pharma columnist and heads IPA CPD E-Times, which is a mouthpiece of International Pharmaceutical Association, IPA, Community Pharmacy Division, CPD. And she comes oftenly on TV news for community pharmacy programs that are aired locally and nationally. Expanding her blend of academics and community pharmacy services, richly poured in for over two decades of services. She is known for her works in consumer education, government authorities, regulatory bodies, pharmacy councils, corporate sectors, and a resource faculty for conducting and training pharmacy practice program of national health importance. She is remembered for the medicine literacy Aushadh Saksharta and is a contributor for leading newspaper on the current usage of medicine. A blessed invited speaker, she is at several international conferences visiting scores of countries for professional representation and participation. Bestowed with several awards throughout her active career and continues to be. To name a few, Fellow of International Pharmaceutical Federation, FIP, in 2016. Initiated Award of Federation Pharmaceutical Association, FAPA, in year 2018 in recognition of her services to the pharmacy community, pharmacy and pharmacy profession. And to mention not, she is a contributor of research publication of high repute and has authored several books, and most sought after is the book entitled Aushadh Bhar, a medicine awareness book. Without further ado, I would like to welcome Mrs. Manjari Ghar to proceed with the session.
Thank you so much. I think this is one of the best introductions for me given in last several years and taking so much efforts collecting the photos. Really appreciate. Thank you for this kind introduction, and I'm really overwhelmed by your introduction. Thank you, Dr. Aziz, and thank you, Saida.
Thank you.
And I'm very happy to be part of this program. Professor Dr. Saida Aziz, the principal of Deccan College and organizing team. Our main speaker, Dr. Deepak Sar Deshmukh, fellow principals, community pharmacist from here, from abroad, and all my dear students. I congratulate the Deccan College for this initiative, which is need of the day today. The patient non-adherence, patient non-compliance, it is really need of the hour, where the pharmacy students and the pharmacists can really make difference in the lives of the patient. Today, when we look at the people, the number of medicines they are taking, the polypharmacy that is increasing so much that we have to intervene and improve the medicine usage. One of my favorite topic and very close to the heart is responsible use of medicines. And when I started working in this area of responsible use of medicine, I realized two, three important things. It is not that the patients are just missing the medicines. It is not that just they are missing the timings, but they are also not taking the medicines according to what they should do before food, after food, at night. There are so many mistakes done. I came across a very eminent personality in Mumbai, and a very well-known freedom fighter, doctor, ENT specialist. He had Parkinson's disease. He was 80 plus then. His son is a very well-known, world-famous industrialist builder. Now, this doctor had Parkinson's disease, and you can imagine they're millionaires. They're getting the best of best treatment in Mumbai. In spite of that, and he had many caretakers, everything was done. In spite of that, even after taking medicines for a few months, his situation did not improve. He was not getting better. The tremors had not reduced. The stiffness had not gone down. Now, his son, industrialist, had gone to United States, and he was talking. He had all the time in his mind, why my father is not getting better when I'm providing everything, every facility to him. And he himself was a doctor, the father. Now, this industrialist son, the builder who is, he started talking to some pharmacist in United States and the clinical pharmacists. And the clinical pharmacist just asked him one question. You are giving this and this medicine, I think levodopa. What is the timing? When are you giving? How are you giving? Now this son said, it is being given after food, after lunch. And the pharmacist immediately said, I can catch the mistake. I can see where is the problem. This drug has to be taken half an hour before food for its good absorption. Now, if the patient is taking it after food, it is never going to have a good bioavailability and there may not be good patient outcome. So this son immediately called up home and told to make the change, that take the medicine before food. And then onwards, the patient's condition improved dramatically in next few days. So this was a small thing, you know, small gap, which was corrected by a clinical pharmacist. And it was nobody in India, in spite of they having such huge hospital network and all the people at their service, nobody had told them, nobody had caught this. And that really the pharmacist can make difference in the lives of the patient by correcting such situations. I see huge potential for the pharmacy profession here. And now, especially now, when the population aging is such a big problem, you can see the demographic transitions in the world. The 28% of the people in Japan are over 65. In India right now, we have more than 8% of our people who are aged, who are elderly. And very soon we are going to have 20% of the population who is going to be above 65. You can imagine our lifespan has increased. In 1947, our average lifespan was around 47 when we got independence. Now our average lifespan is 69 and 67. And many, many people live in 80s, like they don't die till the 80s and 90s. Now, all these people, even though the number of years of life have increased, these years are not healthy. They are taking several medicines, polypharmacy, more than 5 medicines, because they have so many coexisting conditions, comorbidities, hypertension, arthritis, knee pain, depression along with that, insomnia, other cardiac problems, diabetes, everything together. Going to increase in India. Already there are 8%, as I told you, and we are growing this elderly population. This demographic change is really significant. Patient has this responsibility, challenge, and opportunity. I see it as a big challenge catering to the needs of this elderly. I'm not ignoring the other adults, other patients, but what I'm saying is really this geriatric population need our services. They are going to have so many medicines, and they're going to be non-adherence and non-compliance, making their life miserable. Quality of life has gone down. Functional abilities are affected. So I see huge opportunity, huge potential for the pharmacist, and also the huge responsibility on us to make the difference in the lives of our people. So I congratulate again the Deccan College for organizing such webinar where an expert in the field is going to guide these PharmD students as well as going to sensitize the academicians. And this is going to be really helpful. I'm sure at the end of the day, at the end of the session, everybody will be enlightened and inspired to work in this area. I also strongly believe that the charity, we say, no, the charity starts at home. So I believe that it's not going to be charity, but the counseling or the, you know, guidance to the patient start at home. I always tell my students, every student may have some family members who are diabetic, who are start using your knowledge right at your home because you have family members who have some conditions. So start guiding them. It is not that everybody is going to be in the hospital working at the counter or in the community pharmacy, but we are pharmacists in the heart. We have to make this difference in the lives of family members, the community, and then of course, if we are doing the role of practicing pharmacists, we have huge opportunity to contribute to the public health. It is said, it is very well said, in fact, Dr. Deepak Sir Deshmukh might be knowing that in American Pharmacist Association building in Washington, D.C., they have some sculptures. And it is very well written there that what is pharmacy profession? What is the role of pharmacist? It is from making of medicines to making medicines work. I'll just repeat it. From making of medicines to making medicines work. That is the role of pharmacists. The entire range that we have. And so to make medicines work, it is the pharmacist's duty when he's coming in contact with the patients. And so this is really, really an area where we need to put more attention. I have seen so many people because of non-adherence, non-compliance with the BP medicines ending up in ICU, not taking the blood pressure tablets for many days and then ending up in ICU. Why? Because they have just not taken the BP medicine, thinking that my BP is normal now. Never gone for the follow-ups. And then the ICU, the stroke, the paralysis, and all that. It could have been easily avoided by taking that one small tablet. But this is the importance, the significance they need to realize. Their involvement has to increase. And who can do that? Doctors don't have time for it. It is the pharmacist who can talk to the patient, make the purpose, understand why the medicines are taken, and then we can have so many ways, telephonic reminders, SMS to observe and monitor the patients. I know in the United States and in many other countries, there are so many different electronic ways also to monitor the patients. Digital health has become the norm of the day. And there are so many things, you know, that musical, smart pills, smart bottles, that musical bottles, so many things are coming. And I always wonder why so much we need to do through technology, just because people don't take the medicines on time, the way it is needed. So let's try to increase the patient's involvement in the therapy. Let's try to be with them as much as possible. And all the dear students, I congratulate you for choosing this profession. And our pharmacy profession has great social aims. And if you were in some other profession, you might not have got the satisfaction that you may get here in this pharmacy profession. So you have huge opportunity to be the agent of change in the lives of the patient. And the satisfaction that you can get at the end of the day by working for your patients, by bringing the positive change in their lives, it cannot be counted in money. So put your heart and soul in it, and you will get a lot out of it for your life. I wish all the students all the best for their career. In any case, if you need anything, you can always contact me. If you just Google, my information is there, even email IDs are there. So I'm a very accessible person that way. And so if you need, I appeal you to work with IPA and FIP also, and I bring warm greetings from Indian Pharmaceutical Association as well as from International Pharmaceutical Federation. The International Pharmaceutical Federation has recently launched the development goals, 21 development goals. One of the development goals is working with others. Working with others, is that means the interprofessional working with nurses, working with doctors. So many of you being PharmD, I'm sure you're already working with doctors. So I'll encourage that interprofessional working working with others will really give us more, can bring the patient outcomes in a better way. And again, congratulations to Deccan College. Thank you, Dr. Aziz, for inviting me. And again, warm greetings to all of you. And thank you very much. And I wish you all the good luck. Dr. Deepak, I'm sure you're going to be teaching them in such a way that at the end of the session, they will tell me that how good it was and what they have learned. So thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.